Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Hi Aries fire sign, this is January weekly reading and this is general, may or may not resonate everyone. So take what resonate and leave the rest, energy could be vice versa guys. So let's see what are the messages for you and what's going on. Aries. The Moon, Ace of Swords and Page of Pentacles. Ace of Wands, Page of Swords and Seven of Cups. Three of Wands, this could be long distance relationship. You both live in different cities, countries or states. One person turn their back from other person and one person is waiting for the other person. Yeah, it could be you maybe turn your back from your person. Yeah, so let's see your reading. Recent past, the Moon, Ace of Swords and Page of Pentacles. Some communication is coming from your person. Maybe you are in no contact situation. If not, it is going to be happen because Ace of Swords with Page of Pentacles, some message, apology is coming, and the Moon, there are some misunderstandings between both of you, some illusions also. So right now what is going between you and your person? Ace of Wands, Page of Swords and Seven of Wands. Yeah, they want new beginnings with you. If you are in relationship with your person, they want to take this relationship to next level. If you are in separation with your person, they are spying on you. Page of Swords energy. Yeah, you may be spying on them or they may be spying on you on social media, and they want brand new beginnings with you. Ace of Wands. Maybe for some, there are commitment issues between you and your person. That's why the separation had happened or no contact. And Seven of Wands. Maybe you both are, you are also very defensive right now. Because some trust issues, what I'm getting here, because the Moon card is here. That's why you are defensive here. So near future, the Hierophant, Queen of Wands and King of Wands. See, the powerful couple. You both are very powerful couple. And you both stand by your power, you both are grounded and you both are attracted to each other, and there is a lot of passion involved in this connection. See, you are powerful couple, and yes, commitment is coming in your way. The Hierophant is here, definitely marriage, and there will be reconciliation for some. And for some, if you are in relationship, this relationship is going to be next level, that is marriage. Commitment is coming in your way. Yeah, because Queen of Wands and King of Wands, you both are couple here. Definitely some communication, some new beginnings are going to be happen between both of you in near future. And if you are in relationship, there will be some marriage in near future. So the person involved in this connection could be strong fire energy, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, or air energy, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, or earth energy, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. So let's see your person current feelings and their near future actions towards you. Then we will get what's going between both of you. Clarity. And Eight of Swords. Maybe your person right now feeling stuck. So let's see your person current feelings. Aries. Your person current feelings towards you. Yeah, communication, clarity, and under the deck, Libra, they want second chances with you, new beginnings with you. The person involved in this connection could be Libra also. Yeah, Queen of Swords. Yeah, they want to communicate. Some communication is coming in your way. And Six of Pentacles with Queen of Cups. There is no equal give and take in this relationship in past. But now your person want to offer equal give and take. And Queen of Cups, they have strong emotions for you. Because Queen of Cups is here. They have love for you. They want to offer this cup of love to you. They really want to offer stability. So let's see the near future actions towards you. Aries, your person near future actions. All pairs. Maybe the person involved in this connection could be Leo. They are getting this strength back to come towards you. Yeah. So let's see, here see, Queen of Swords, King of Swords, Queen of Cups, King of Cups. think you both are on the same page, you both are on the same level, okay? Because you both are perfect couple for each other, because three couple cards here, because King of Wands, Queen of Wands, King of Swords, Queen of Swords, King of Cups and Queen of Cups. You both are on the same page. If you are in separation, if you are not in separation, that doesn't matter, because you both love each other. There is a lot of love and you both want to communicate with each other. And there is a lot of passion is also involved in this connection. Yeah, I think you both will communicate very soon if you are in separation, in no contact. If you are not in separation, definitely this is a, I think, unbreakable bond between both of you. Strong soulmate connection, what I'm getting here, because there are so much similarities between both of you. You both have strong emotions for each other and you both want to communicate with each other. You both are very attracted to each other. You both are very powerful couple. Yeah, this is destined connection what I'm getting here. So the person involved in this connection could be Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, and Seven of Pentacles here. They really want to invest on this connection. So let's pull some cards from universe where this connection is headed on and outcome. Aries. Yeah, they're thinking about you a lot. Again, soulmates, I already told you, Two of Cups is here. And this is the mutual love between both of you. You both love each other. And yeah, they're missing you so much. They're thinking about you a lot. Nine of Swords energy, when especially they're alone. And Six of Wands, they want success in this connection. For some, your person is already successful. They are very attractive person. Yeah, I think you are also very abundant person. That's why you both are very successful and very attractive person. And you right now, for some, you are concentrating on your career and goals and working towards your abundance. And the Emperor, yeah, you always committed to this person. You always there for your person. For some, there are some ego problems. Yeah, they really have strong emotions. You both are on the same page. Yeah, under the deck, the Fool, new beginnings. Definitely, you both want new beginnings with each other. You both are on the same page. You both are successful. You both are very hardworking. So yeah, they're missing you so much if you are in separation. I think you both want same thing in this connection. This is destined connection and the bond between both of you is unbreakable. So the person involved in this connection could be Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius or Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. So let's see your overall energy, Aries, for the week. Yeah, I think, again, see, Nine of Swords, your person card and you both are on the same page. You both are missing each other a lot. Yeah, you are also feeling sad for the separation. There is love between both of you, the Lovers card. The person involved in this connection could be Gemini. Yeah, you are also a very powerful person. You stand by your power and you are very grounded. Yeah, you are waiting for your person. You are also thinking about them a lot. So let's see your person overall energy for the week. Again, strong soulmate connection, mutual love, the Sun. Yeah, they're really hoping for this connection. And Eight of Cups, separation. And yeah, they're missing you so much. They're missing you badly. They're suffering in silence. If they walked away from you, they're feeling very sad for that, for the decision. And they want happiness. They're thinking about you very positively. And this is a strong bond, unbreakable bond between both of you. Yeah, reconciliation. Definitely there will be new beginnings between both of you guys. Major, but very few, it depends. Most of you will be reconciled, but let's see some messages from Moon Oracle Jack for you. Aries, balance, spirituality and practicality. Yeah, so it is the time for you, balance. So if you are working hard towards your goals, there is no time for your spiritual things. There is no time for your meditation. So if you are doing more meditation, not giving any time to your work. So this is the message from universe: balance spirituality and practicality. Okay, you have to balance both the things, and especially when full moon in Pisces. Yeah, this is the message from universe. So this is the reading for you guys. Hope it resonates to you. Please do share, like and subscribe my channel and click the bell icon. Then you will get all my video notification. Thank you so much for watching and supporting me. Bye.